Good morning, students. Hope you all stay safe in home. My name is Saranya. I'm teaching social for you. Today we are going to see one new topic. Shall we see? Come. The topic is occupation. In this section, we are going to see what is means of occupation and what are the types we are going to see. What is the meaning of occupation? Occupation is working and earning money for his or her living. So we are working and earning money, that is called occupation. That we need basic things to live. For that we need money. For money we are working in certain companies or business, etc. So that occupation gives us money. So we are using from that. Some different types of occupations are famous in each district. Example, Bangalore is famous for IT. So each district is famous for one individual occupation. For example, Bangalore is famous for IT department. The next, we are going to see some examples. Each and everything we use in our day-to-day life is made by some group of people. See around your room, the table is there, chair is there. How we can get table? From the furniture shop. Where they will get? They will get from the carpenter. The carpenter will get, where will the carpenter will get wood? The carpenter will get wood from the woodcutter. So behind one table or chair, many peoples are working. So for buying this, we are paying money. So we are giving money and we are getting that. That is also one type of occupation for the seller who is selling to us. For example, grocery shop, departmental stores, furniture shop, etc. In grocery shop, what we are buying? We are buying rice, flour, etc. Where they will get? They will get from the farmer who is harvesting the rice, vegetables, etc. So, behind one type of product, so many people are working. The persons following one occupation depends on the persons following other occupation. Example, observe this picture, how your clothes have been made. So we are going to see how our clothes have been made. See the first picture, they are harvesting cotton. The second one, they are removing the seeds, that is called ginning. The third one, in the spinning wheel, they are converting the cotton into thread. The fourth one, they are making that white one to colored and they are drying. We need the several colors, right? So for that they are dyeing and drying that. The next one, they are weaving. They are converting the thread into cloths. Then they are selling that cloths. We buy the cloth and we gave to the tailor. What the tailor will do? The tailor will stitch. Finally, our new dress. Behind one dress, so many people are working, like harvesting, ginning, spinning, dyeing and drying, weaving, selling the cloth, stitching. After that only, we are getting cloth. So occupation depends on other people's. Here is your homework. You have to do your homework. The first one, make a list of occupation. You have to write the occupation's names. Second one, what do you want to become and why? In future, what do you want to become and what is the reason for that? You have to write one paragraph. Third one, what is your hobby? In your free time, what you will do? Don't write, I will watch TV, I will play. Like hobby means I was interested in doing craft, I was interested in doing drawing, like that. You have some hobbies, some interest, you have to write that. The final one, you have to explain the given occupations. Farmer, carpenter, teacher, doctor, driver. You have to explain these occupations in one or two, three sentences, like a paragraph. Each paragraph you have to write. That's all for this section, students. Thank you. We'll meet in the next section. Stay home, stay safe.